Hey there, internet travelers. What can you learn from this video? How about this? That right over here was my first ever home after I was born, particularly this apartment right here. So, like every time most of the time, my parents would take us up here, we'd drive past here and they'd always point out, hey, that's where you first lived. After you were born, and apparently it hasn't really changed much. Here's a little more view of it. I would be outside the car, but for one, we're next to a busy street and it's windy outside. So I thought this might be a little easier to hear me this way. But yeah, what's a little funny story is, so after my parents moved out with me, because we just lived there for about 3 months, and then we moved to Waco, Texas, where one of my younger brothers was born, but it's where my dad did his residency. And anyway, after we moved out, there was an aunt and uncle of mine that moved into that apartment, and they were having fun repainting and like painting names, their names on the wall, and I love you. And they didn't realize if you don't immediately paint right over, you can still see it. So for a while, it still said, I love you on the wall, I guess. And until they finally did some more painting. But just a little funny story and a cautionary tale to, yeah, you can have fun, but hurry and finish the painting. Don't let it dry. But yeah, this was 1983. And that's the same year that there was a really big snow. Secondary to this year. Like, we just recently broke the record for the snowpack. Like, historical record. And what happened that year was it had a lot of snow, but then suddenly it got hot really fast. And so a lot of it melted, and they even had a river down State Street, which is a road that goes from the state capitol all the way through Utah. It breaks up in little parts, especially now, but like when it was first made, yeah, it went all the way to St. George. I'll put a link to a nice short news story that reflects on that incident just here at the end of the video. But yeah, it was a big ordeal, and some people are worried about it this year, but it's been pointed out there's a lot better drainage now. Homes are built a little higher than they were on the street. And though, one more funny story. More of a mystery and sort of story. So I have a, not nephew, younger cousin that has some autism. And anyway, when he was a toddler, there were two instances that they still don't know how it happened. Like, one, they found him like in the middle of the street, like on the median there. Back when it was only like two lanes on either side, maybe even one lane on either side. I don't know. It was, I think it was even this 7th East Street. And, but it was one of the really busy streets like this. Busy for back then. Not as busy now, I would think. But anyway, yeah, they don't know. How was he sitting there in the middle? And then another one is, you see here, like how it's pointed at that top of the roof there. They found him on the roof one time. And both these times, he's a toddler. It's like, wait, how'd he do this? How'd he get there? And so, there's your funny stories and a little glimpse at what was my first home. Yeah, it's amazing how some places stay around that long. Can you find your first home? like on Google Maps and Street, Google Streets. It'd be a interesting thing for, I think, anyone. And yeah, as always, y'all keep smiling.